Now coming to next question of the puzzle, it says that M, N, O, P, Q, R, S and T are seated in a straight line. They are 8 people. Then it says that some of them are facing south while some of them are facing north. And there is a note that same direction means if one is facing north, then other is also facing north and vice versa. And opposite direction means that if one is facing north, then other is facing south. Then it says that Q faces north and there is two connectors that only 3 people sit to the third right of Q and only 2 people sit between Q and M. Now, Q faces north, so definitely Q is here as only 3 people sit to it, third right. Then N, between N and Q there are 2 people. So if N is there, then there are 2 people. But N can also be here, so this is the another case. Now it says that R sits third to the right of T. T is an immediate neighbor of neither Q nor N, and T does not sit at any extreme ends of the line. Now from this we can conclude in the first case T cannot come here, 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 only this place is left for T, as T cannot be at extreme ends and T cannot be the neighbor of Q or N. Now as R sits third to the left of T, so T will face north and R will come here. Now in the second case where Q is facing north and N is here, T cannot be at these places. But if T is here and he is facing north, then its third left is nowhere. And if his face is south, then his third left is Q, which is not filled by R. So T cannot be here also. Now if T is here, then R will be here if he faces south. Now further it says that both the immediate neighbors of the P face south. P is not an immediate neighbor of T and only one person sits between P and M. Now there are 3 information about P. That P is not the neighbor of T. So in this case P cannot come here. And then at these 2 places, if we fit P here, then P do not has 2 neighbors. And it says that both the immediate neighbors of P. So P has 2 neighbors. Okay. So P will be here. And as between P and M there is 1 people, so N is here. And it says that M faces the same direction as T. And T is facing north, so M will face north. And further it says that immediate neighbors of N face opposite direction. Now N, one's neighbor is facing north, so other neighbor will face south. Okay. Now further it says that O faces same direction as that of P. P is facing south, O will face also south. And there is one line that person sitting at any extreme end face opposite directions. Now M is at extreme end and he is facing north, so other will face south. Okay. And I have written wrong. O faces direction opposite that of P. P is facing south, so O is facing north. And there are 2 places where O can come, and this person is facing south, so O cannot be here and O will definitely be here facing north. And the last person remaining, that is S, will be here. Now we don't know the direction about N and R. We have to figure out their direction. Now which information is left now? We can see that both the immediate neighbors of P face south, and P's immediate neighbors are N and R, and they will face south. So this is our final case. Now we can reject second case, as P is not an immediate neighbor of T, so P cannot be here, P cannot be here, P cannot be here, as then there is no position for M, and P cannot be here also, as there is no position for M. So this case is ruled out. In exams you have to take a chance by considering only one case and it will give you a answer. Now, first question related to this puzzle says, how many persons are seated between Q and M? We can see there is 1, 2, 3 persons are sitting between Q and M. Answer is option number 4. Thank you.